Hello, Malty Mediterranean Mammoths, and thank you to NASA Crooks for that mention. I'm Ralfy, welcome to the Manx Bothy, somewhere in the Irish Sea, and welcome to Ralfy Review 748. I have a bottle of, was I about to say Scotch whiskey? No. I was about to say single malt whiskey from England. Excuse me, I'd like to repeat that again, because some viewers are going to be shocked. They're going to say, Ralfy, what's going on? Does England produce whiskey? I thought Scotch whiskey was supposed to be from Scotland. That's why you've got all the tartan and the deer and the haggis and the heather and all that stuff about the water. No, times have changed. The world, malt mates, the world has moved on. And I am delighted, as a proud Scotsman, I am delighted to be introducing Cotswolds single malt whiskey, distilled in 2014, bottled in 2018. Yes, it's 4 year old English single malt. I can also tell you that has been made from English local barley of a particularly good quality. In fact, they state the barley variety on the label. Allow me to give you a little bit of label information before we proceed. Rightio. Odyssey barley, sourced locally, as in locally to the distillery. The sort of thing that Bruichladdy does and Springbank do. It's all part of the integrity of the presentation. And I won't be a minute. We're experiencing very wet weather over the Irish Sea at the moment. And when you're in a small island surrounded by sea, things get very, very ambiently damp. And of course, the steampunker mists up. So what have we got here? Distilled and bottle blended, distilled and blended, still a single malt, blended and bottled in the Cotswolds, England, UK. From Warminster Maltings, now that's a fine old family traditional business that goes back many generations. That's one of the old timers, Warminster. And it is the first ever Cotswolds single malt whiskey from specially selected first fill barrels, non-chill filtered and bottled at 46%. I would also suggest that's natural colour as well. In fact, I'm pretty sure it is. This, for your reference, if you're looking for a similar bottle, is bottled batch 8550. There we go. Bottled in March 2018. Splendid stuff. There's a little bit of gubbins in the back and a little bit in the label round the neck, but I'm not going to go there. What I will say is that before I smell and taste this and give a malt mark, just so we can get our bearings, there's Lake District Distillery in England. In fact, there's the English Distillery Company down in Norfolk. There's a number of distilleries about to open in England, which I'm looking on with great interest because they really seem to be focusing on intrinsic quality of smell and taste. And in this instance, as a four-year-old single malt, what has struck me is actually the calibre of the experience for such a young age. And this has really happened purely because of the quality of ingredients used, the quality of the cask, and the calibre of the maturation in what would essentially be termed a traditional warehouse. It really shows. There has been no dressing up or cosmeticization of this whisky with the use of secondary casks or special finishes, which are happening so frequently now with Scotch whisky, often with disappointing results. And I do, as a proud Scotsman, I'm very much aware that I would sooner have a good English whisky over a bad Scotch whisky, because it's about the quality of the experience at the end of the day, and it's a global village. period. So you won't find me doing any haggis bashing and tartan tantrums. None of that. It's a family-owned distillery. It's not very small. It's north of Bristol, south of Birmingham, west of Cambridge, and east of the Irish Sea. There you go. Right in the heart of England. If you were to imagine the epitome of English rural tranquil countryside, as you would find in old romantic novels, this is where the distillery is located. And I can now focus on the nose now. I've given you an introduction to Cotswolds. If you are planning a visit to the distillery, I think you'll find it very rewarding, very comprehensive, good quality tour, and probably best to phone ahead and book your tour before, rather than just turn up. Just a suggestion. The smell immediately is one that exceeds expectations for a four-year-old single malt. It is wonderfully rich, semi-sweet, barley sugar, toffee, and a little bit of slightly less fruity sultana notes in the background. There is also some fresh almond notes about it. I'm not going as far as to say marzipan. It's a little bit too young for that marzipan complexity to have developed, which I think will appear over time. But certainly at this early stage, you have a good, prominent, fresh almond note, which is quite substantial in character. I'm also noticing in the nose a real depth of note. There's a sort of grain sour going on with some grain fruitiness, some grain esteriness in the nose. And then again, this is probably a result of longer than usual fermentation times. And also something which I find very, very encouraging from this single malt is that the owners of the distillery who are producing the stuff, really at a very early stage, they know what they're doing. That there's evidence in the smell, even before we get to the taste, there's evidence in the smell that the experience in producing whiskey is really showing, because it hasn't been over distilled. And this is a big, big problem with many young, inexperienced distillers. They make the heart or the cup from the still, from a copper pot still, which is what Cotswolds are using. They're using Forsyth stills, Scottish traditional copper pot stills. In this instance, you're getting a good hefty cut, a brave cut you might call it, where they've started earlier in the foreshots and they've pushed into the feints to bring in the more risky, rougher, slightly fusile notes that you get as the temperature of the still goes up and the length of the distillation goes on. It's been done here with confidence, and I must commend the producers for the caliber of the result. Taste, I'm going to taste it neat now. What a good cask. One thing on the nose is that complexity suggests that palate is not going to be too sweet. Mercifully, this is not a sweet whiskey. If anything, this is a confidently sour, dry, slightly bitter whiskey, which blends in beautifully with these almond presence and barley sugar notes, the grain rich complexity, the intrinsic spirit driven complexity that we're getting from the experience. It dovetails superbly in with what the cask is offering and has given so little actually in 4 years, but it's amounted up to so much. So there's some single malts. If this was a Scottish single malt, you know, I'm getting as much from this at 4 years as you could get from a Scotch single malt after 10 or even 12. And that speaks for itself. I'm going to add some water now. It won't take long for it to open up, being such a young, spirit-driven experience. I'm going to add, about a teaspoon, 5 millimetres from the silver spoon, before I dish out a malt mark. It doesn't increase the complexity, but it does soften the nose slightly. and just give a slightly more restrained version of the malt when it was undilute. Certainly increases the mouthfeel. I'm curious to see actually if any English mist appears in the glass, which should be a sign of non-chill filtration from pot still single malt from barley. It has been kind of restrained so far, but this could be partly to do with location, the proximity of the distillery in relation to Scotland, because it's well south. It literally is a different climate. It's a much softer climate. I notice to a certain extent the same thing with Pendidden Welsh whisky. Big full arrival, bitter, slightly sweet, bitter sour, substantial, characterful, develops without much complexity, a little bit of sour apple and a little bit of soft ginger, a little touch of savoury herbal notes, soft sage, hint of mint into the finish, really just a continuity of the development, some soft gingery notes, light, complex, a little bit of jasmine tea, dry jasmine tea, a little bit of gunpowder tea there, some cold vanilla notes, and some barley sugar, some semi-sweet, slightly soured barley sugar. So malt mark time. There is an aftertaste of overt youthfulness to this whisky, but you know what? No wonder, it's 4 years old. So I'm not going to bring it down because of that. This is a decent, modern, contemporary, integrity bottling. And I'm going to come back to the word integrity shortly. Bear in mind that integrity. That's going to be a buzzword for 2019. Integrity distilleries. There needs to be clearer understanding of what constitutes the modern interpretation of good whiskey versus generic whiskey, which is increasingly, unfortunately, overpriced. 86 out of 100, I'd say that's a pretty decent malt mark for a 4-year-old single malt. It's Ralfy recommended. I hope you enjoy it. And the fact that it's English whiskey, jolly good. I look forward to seeing more English whiskey, because if there's one thing out there that will help Scotch whiskey hold on to its reputation and deliver better quality bottles to the market for customers to buy, do you know what it's called? It's called competition from other countries, and I'm all for that. Cheers, my dears. Salute.